My name is Mark Gallagher, and I've spent my career working in the sports business of Formula One motor racing. I'm very pleased to have worked with the Promotivate speakers agency on many occasions. And when I speak at conferences around the world, I speak on a wide range of topics, including leadership, teamwork, innovation, risk management, digital transformation, and coping with change. And of course, change is what we're seeing at the moment around the world, affecting all businesses because of the coronavirus. It's an existential threat for many organizations. But in Formula One, we're well used to meeting such challenges. We're well used to what happens when something outside of your control threatens your very existence. In 2000, we saw the effects of the dot-com bubble bursting. We saw a number of major technology partners and customers disappear almost overnight. In 2005, tobacco advertising and sponsorship was banned. And that cost us major revenue streams. Companies that we had been reliant upon for customers for many years suddenly were no longer permitted to do business with us. In 2008, the global financial crisis had a major effect on our industry. We saw the disappearance of many customers, both individuals and companies. We saw major partners, companies like Toyota and BMW and Honda, withdraw from our sector again almost overnight. So we've become very good at being resilient. We've become very good at adapting to change and recognizing that actually change is ever present. I think that's partly because we're used to working in a technology environment and technology is ever changing. So Formula One teams have diversified into becoming broad-based technology businesses. And that's one of the reasons why in the midst of the coronavirus challenge, so many Formula One teams have actually stopped motor racing and repurposed their entire manufacturing and engineering facilities in order to produce the components and assemblies needed to produce much needed ventilators and breathing aids for healthcare services across Europe and indeed around the world. We've also seen major change in recent weeks in Formula One with the launch of a virtual Formula One World Championship in which real racing drivers for teams like Ferrari and Red Bull Racing, are actually online racing professional gamers and indeed amateur gamers in a virtual environment. We can't race in the real world, so let's race in a virtual domain. And that's extremely exciting. We've seen huge audiences, 500,000 people tuning in on computers and devices, mobile devices in our connected world in order to enjoy Formula One in a virtual environment because the real world is shut down. I have no doubt that this time of challenge is going to produce some very major benefits when we get to the far side. People will again have learned the benefit of teamwork between individuals, of collaboration between companies, including competitors, and across our supply chains. Most of all, we will have come to realize the fragile environment within which we all work and live, our need to be agile, to develop resilience, to manage the risks, and as human beings to work together to produce positive, wonderful outcomes. I've no doubt that that will be the case.